My name is Eurydice Kanimba, PhD. To me, that P stands for problem solver, because I'm a mechanical engineer. Mechanical engineering involves combining physics law with your imagination and try to come up with a really finished product. I really do enjoy thinking about an object or thinking about a design and analyzing how you can make that a reality. I was born in 1993, and that was a year before the tragic genocide that happened in my country. That also sort of molded my path into wanting to be better for my family. We faced a lot of tragedy. It's like we have a mission to accomplish, and that really kept me going. Coming here, it was a little hard at first. Navigating, getting used to actually speaking a new language. There was ASME student chapter, and I went to their meeting. I just took it as an opportunity for me to actually start forming relations and start being involved in an organization or a community that is willing to support. If you immerse yourself within it, you can reach your destination. My second year, I signed up to be the secretary and then moved on from secretary to vice president to then president in my senior year. I was awarded the Willis Thompson Scholarship in 2013. My parents, at the time, they were supporting five of us, so it was a lot on their shoulder. And when I told them that I was awarded that, they were really amazed and very thankful for sure. ASME just came at the right time. After that, I moved on and I was awarded two more ASME scholarships in graduate school. And that keeps you going, knowing that there's actually an organization that cares about what you're doing and the work that you put in. That also provides you more courage or more, you feel much more hopeful. My research involved the modeling of bio-inspired structures. One of them is called the cuttle bone, which is the inner shell of the cuttlefish. The cuttlefish lives at the bottom of the sea where the pressure are pretty high, close to 600 psi. The cuttle bone has very good mechanical properties and it can sustain a lot of compressive strength. The exterior of a spacecraft system experiences a huge amount of pressure during travel because there's friction between the air and the exterior when it's re-entering into the atmosphere. Now you really need a structure that can be able to maintain the form and the shape of the spacecraft. So the cuttle bone has a very high compressive strength. This is a 3D printed version of it. With a computer model of this, you can do a lot of modeling analysis with different type of material.
Last time when we met, mm-hmm. I asked you to create a code book mm-hmm. for the studies.
I believe that we need diverse thought, especially in engineering. There is more than one way of solving an engineering problem. Being a girl from Rwanda, I grew up with totally different perspective than someone here. It really gives me joy by giving back because I now know that the process that I've gone through can sort of be an example for others. I can share my story so a young girl who is starting off engineering can see, oh, it's possible. A lot of people think that engineers are lab rats or glued to their computers. You'll be surprised to know that I've actually won a silver medal nationwide in ping-pong. My name is Eurydice Kanimba, and I am a rocket scientist.